अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाह। हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू मैथ क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी मोर अबाउट डेसिमल्स। लास्ट क्लास वी लर्न्ड डेसिमल मल्टीप्लिकेशन विद द होल नंबर। टुडे लेट अस लर्न ईजीएस्ट वे ऑफ डेसिमल मल्टीप्लिकेशन विद 10, 100 and 1000। All of you take your notebook and write heading multiplication of decimal by 10, 100 and 1000. Okay, let us take the decimal 6.235. Multiply with 10. 6.235 into 10. When we multiply a decimal by 10, we shift the decimal point, we move the decimal point one place to the right. Answer is 6.235 into 10 is equal to 62.35. Multiply with 10, we move the decimal point one place to the right. In the same way, when we multiply a decimal by 100, the decimal points move to two places to the right. For example, 6.235 into 100 is equal to 623.5. Move the decimal point two places to right. Similarly, when we multiply a decimal by thousands, the decimal point shifts three places to the right. Example, 6.235 into 1000 is equal to 6235. Remember, to multiply by 10, 100 and 1000, shift the decimal point as many places to the right as there are zero after 1. Write down the questions. 63.5 into 10, 749.8 into 100, 3.04 into 10, 9.004 into 1000, 0.002 into 10, 31.47 into 100. Write down the old questions. In first one, 63.5 into 10. There is only one decimal point. There is only one decimal number after the decimal point. When multiply with 10, you have to move one number before the decimal point. So answer is 635. 63.5 answer is 635. In second one, 749.8 into 100. In this question, multiply with 100. When multiply with 100, you have to move two places after the decimal number to before the decimal number. Here, 749.8, only one decimal number. So put 10 when multiply with 100. 749.8 into 100 is equal to 74,980. Third one, 3.04 into 10. Just move one decimal number before the decimal point. Answer is 30.4. Next, 9.004 into 1000. When multiply with 1000, move three places, three decimal places before the decimal point. So answer is 9.004 into 1000 is equal to 9004. Next, 0.002 into 10. Here, multiplication with 10. So move one decimal place to left. Answer is 0.02. Next, 31.47 into 100. Multiply with 100, move two decimal places to left. So, answer is 3147. All of you clear? Now, let us move to the next topic. Right heading, multiplication of decimal by another decimal number. Multiplication of decimal by another decimal. Let us see how we can multiply two decimal numbers. Look at the question given here. All of you write the question. Find the product of 1.23 and 0.7. To multiply two decimal numbers, there are few rules. Let us see the rules one by one. So the first rule is to ignore the decimal point and multiply the normal procedure. Take the number 123 into 7. Ignore the decimal point. When multiply 7 with 123, we will get the answer 861. After multiplication, you have to put decimal point in the answer. Now, the next step is to put the decimal point at the correct place. How do we decide where to put the decimal point? To find out where to put the decimal point, you have to count the number of digits after the decimal point in both multiplier and the multiplicand. So here we have done the multiplication and we got the product. So in 1.23, how many digits are there after the decimal point? There are two digits, and 0.7, there is only one digit. So you have to add the number of digits in the multiplier and the multiplicand. Here you have two digits in first one and one digit in second one. Therefore, the total number of digits after the decimal point is equal to 2 plus 1, 3. So, there should be 3 decimal places in the answer. So, final answer is 0.861. Okay, 1.23 into 0.7 is equal to 0.861. I hope this is clear to you. Now, let us see one more question. Write down the second question. Multiply 32.34 into 45.22. Let's start. First, ignore the decimal point of multiplier and multiplicand. When we multiply 3234 into 4522, we get the product is 1,46,24,148. Now the next step is to put the decimal point at the correct place. How do we decide where to put the decimal point? To find out where to put the decimal point, you have to count the number of digits after the decimal point, both the multiplier and the multiplicand. 32.34, second, 45.22. Here we have done the multiplication and we got the product. In 32.34, how many digits after the decimal point? There are two digits, and 45.22 also two digits. So you have to add the number of digits in the multiplier and multiplicand. So here you have two digits in first one and also two digits in second one. Therefore, the total number of digits after the decimal point 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. So there should be 4 decimal places in the answer. So final answer is 1462.4148. Okay, write down this question. Multiply 3.25 into 1.4, 426.4 into 12.4, 3.5 into 1.4, 42.04 into 3.3, 2.159 into 3.24. These are your homework. Find the product and send me your answer. Next topic, division of decimal numbers. Firstly, division decimal number by a whole number. Write heading, division of a decimal by a whole number. We have learned the addition of decimal, subtraction and multiplication of decimal numbers. Now let us learn how we can divide a decimal number by a whole number. Now look at this question given here. Write down the question. Divide 5.732 by 4. Divide 5.732 by 4. The dividend is 5.732, which is the decimal number, and we have a divisor 4, which is a whole number. Let us find the quotient. Like in the same division steps of whole numbers, first write the dividend and divisor. I told you the division process is the same as the division of whole numbers, but we have to pay an extra care in where to put the decimal point in the quotient. So let us proceed the divisions. We are dividing by one digit number. Look here, we have done the all division steps and we got quotient. In the question, how many digits are there after the decimal point? 5.732. There are 3 digits. So there should be 3 decimal places in the quotient. 5.732 divided by 4 is equal to 1.433. Okay, let us end today's class here. Please note some more homework. 62.5 divided by 5, 3.88 divided by 8, 3270 divided by 3. Complete your all homework and send it to school WhatsApp number. Okay, thank you.